Another episode of the Love Works show. For those of you who don't know who I am yet, I'm Nicole Moore. I am a love coach, love expert, love teacher. I help women attract what I call a top 1% man, a man that is amazing on every single level. And then I show you how to keep him. And in the Love Works show, I share behind the scenes of what the love life of a love coach is really like. I give love and relationship tips and really share about what I'm seeing happening in love. And so the topic of this show is attracting the one by being who you really are. I talk about this a lot in my programs, like Man Attraction Bootcamp especially. But what sparked this topic was I was actually reading Elle magazine with the beautiful Gal Gadot on top of it, on the cover. So I love Elle magazine. I've always loved Elle magazine. I would love to be in Elle magazine one day for sure, because I just think they have really great articles. And so I was reading, you know, the piece about, you know, Gal Gadot, who is Wonder Woman. And there was a couple of interesting things that I wanted to pull out for you, because it actually ties into this topic. And so, and by the way, if you're watching, say hi. I'd love to know who's watching. So one of the things that we're talking about in the article, hi Gabby. One of the things that we're talking about in the article, when they're talking about, you know, obviously she plays Wonder Woman in Wonder Woman, and they were talking about the director and her vision for the character, and I thought this was so interesting, because the director, yeah, I love her too, right? She's so amazing. So the director, they actually kind of changed the team, because one person had a vision of Wonder Woman as being this kind of dark character. You know, a lot of superheroes are actually kind of dark and damaged. And the director, Patty Jenkins, had a different vision. And she said, so many people's assumptions about what would make a tough woman is actually a damaged woman. People were confusing strength with defensiveness. And I was like, why would she be defensive? She totally trusts people. Why would she be angry? She assumes that she's going to be treated well. She has no chip on her shoulder. And so I love that when they're describing that, because if you've watched the movie Wonder Woman, you know this is how the character is, right? She's very open. She's very loving. She trusts people. She believes in people. She goes to Earth to kind of try and save everyone with this really open, vulnerable attitude. And this is a piece about actually being who you really are to attract the one. So, you know, what they said was so brilliant here, that people confused being defensive with strength. Hi, Michelle. Hi, Rebecca. Hi, Jennifer. And that's actually not the case. So I want you to ask yourself right now, are you being the truth of who you are in relationship? And what I mean by that is, are you showing up open? Are you showing up with no chip on your shoulder? Nobody is born with a chip on their shoulder. Every human being is actually born really super loving. And being loving is actually the truth of who you are, especially for women. But what happens is, as we go along and we date and we have these experiences, we start to confuse, like they said, toughness, like I'm a strong woman, with this defensiveness, with this anger against men, with this unwilling to open. And if you've watched the movie Wonder Woman, you probably fell in love with her, not because she's this beautiful Amazon woman, like she's gorgeous, right? But it was that quality that you could tell in her, that she really kind of had this beautiful, open, loving heart. She believed in people. Hey, Vidya. Ah, thanks for the right spelling of my name. So this is one key to attracting in the one, attracting in the person who's right for you. What is the quality of your heart before it was hurt? Go back and remember. And I know some people watching don't have that experience, because you feel like you were hurt since you came onto this earth from your parents and all of that. But try and remember, what's the quality of your heart before, like, the rules of what you should do with your, like, how much you should give to a man or not, before, should I share my real self or not, before, what's the right thing to say? What is the quality of your heart when it is undefended? That's what you want to give to people, because that's how you attract in the one. But here's the deal. You also want to have your discernment, right? So when you get back to the state of what your heart really is, this desire to love, and you have the ways you love. Some people show it by, you know, words. Some people show it by cooking. Some people show it by acts of service. When you get back to that state of what your heart really wants to do, what your heart would do naturally if it wasn't trying to be tough and defend itself. I want you to take a moment and actually write down, like, what are the ways that I actually like to love? Because the truth is, and Don Miguel Ruiz says this in The Mastery of Love, it's the love that's coming out of you that makes you happy. So you see this in children, right? Like, children are very loving. They just beam love out. And we all start that way. And then we love people. And then we don't get the response back that we like. And then we decide that there's something wrong with this, right? There's something wrong with the way I want to love. There's something wrong with the way I naturally am. So let me change that, guard that, defend that, right? And then we become these unnatural beings. And then we're an unnatural being trying to attract in someone who is the one. What's the one? The one is someone who you meet and they feel like a really good match for you. And you decide, like, this is someone I want to spend the rest of my life with. But I'm all about having you attract in that man who's really a match for you. And it's very hard to do that if you're operating in ways of being that are actually unnatural to who you are. So take the example of Wonder Woman, where she was this beautiful, strong woman, but she was very open. She was very trusting. She was very loving. And there's such beauty and pureness in that. And that's a very attractive energy. So I've been hurt in my love life. I've been hurt in my life. But what I developed in myself was the ability to keep my heart open no matter what. Even when I went through a lot of pain, I cherished my heart. I cherished my ability to love. And I kind of maintained this, like, purity. I don't know if you guys can feel it. If you can, you can let me know. But I've heard this from so many healers and people who read my energy, and they will always say, like, you have a very pure energy. And the reason isn't because I never got hurt. The reason is because I understood the value of that state of the original heart before it's hurt. You know, they say, unless you're like a little child, you won't enter the kingdom of heaven, right? What does that mean? I don't really believe that there's anyone standing there going, you're not going to enter heaven. I believe it means on this present moment, in this present earth, until you learn to bring your heart back to that open, vulnerable, natural state, you're not going to experience the heaven that a relationship can be. Because heaven in a relationship is when you feel free. Heaven in a relationship is when you feel entirely free to be exactly who you are. And you feel safe in that. That's what I experienced in my relationship with my husband, Mike. I literally never, ever, ever, ever have to hide any part of who I am ever. I wouldn't even think about it. I share me entirely, the amazingness or the not so amazingness, and it's all accepted by him. But how I got to attracting in that person in the first place was by letting go of the guardedness and the defensiveness against my heart. And I understood that gentle strength is actually the most powerful strength. It's way more powerful than defensiveness. So I want you to start imagining the version of you that has this really beautiful, open, undefended, trusting heart, the heart you were born with. But then there's also this other part of you that has your back, that knows what you want, that will not settle, that values what's in here. So you, and that part is kind of watching out for you. And if you have that, you can actually go out and date in the world, because your heart won't be taken advantage of. See, what most women do is they're hurt, and then it's like, I want you to imagine this image of this beautiful heart, and then you get hurt, and then there's like a barking guard dog around. You know, like when you walk up to a house and the dogs are like, oh, whoa, 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 right? It's scary, and you're like, oh, geez. Most women do that because they can't deal with the fact that their heart was hurt because it's painful. And so they put like that guard dog around their heart, and then they're trying to get the love of their life. Can you see how that's such a mismatch? And you don't even attract in the one from that place. But instead, you can actually go in and heal your heart. And then you don't have to have a guard dog around your heart. You can have, if you can imagine it, like a beautiful goddess that understands what's inside here. And so she's leaning back and assessing, is this man a good match for me to let in or not? But that's a very different energy than the guardedness and the defendedness. So I love that. And there's one other, another thing I want to share from this article. So what they were saying is when Gal Gadot came, when she wanted to be in movies, she got a voice coach to change her accent. And she went and she said, you know what? Like, what do I have to do? I want to speak like an American woman. Like, put me in a boot camp. I'll come 3 days a week. And the voice coach was like, no, it's not going to happen. Like, no matter what you do, your accent isn't going to fully go away. And she's like, no, whatever it takes, I'll do it. And the voice coach was like, she said, you know what? There are already a million American women who look more American than you, who sound more American than you. Because Gal Gadot, she didn't want to just be typecast as the exotic woman, right? She didn't just want to play that part. And she was thinking, there's no leading characters that look like I do, that have the accent that I have, you know? And so she was trying to change herself to be more agreeable to get to her goal. And I thought it was so brilliant that her coach said, I'm trying to find the quote. She said, do you have any idea how many Americans there are in Los Angeles looking for roles who look more American than you, sound more American than you, just be you? And as you know, she became a leading lady all in her own right, and she didn't have to change who she was. And in fact, they decided for the movie Wonder Woman that an American wasn't the best part, that of course she should have this like international flavor. And this is something that I teach my clients so much. You do not have to change who you fundamentally are to get the love of your life. Now, you may have patterns, okay? Like going to crazy town about a man is not who you fundamentally are, I promise. Being defensive and angry and guarded is not who you fundamentally are. So I don't mean that. You do have to change the patterns that you've created that are getting in the way of you finding love. But I'm talking about who you fundamentally are, the way that you look, what you really enjoy in life, what you find interesting in life, your vision. You don't have to change that to get the love of your life. Gal Gadot did not have to change her accent to become a leading lady, even though the popular idea is leading ladies sound a certain way. Instead, she was fully her, and she got there anyway in the embracing of who she is, not in the rejecting of who she is. And that is such a big, 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 big key. So if you are someone who is thinking, I have to change fundamental aspects of who I am, I want you to see if you can actually let that go and start to envision a reality where you get what you want anyway. Now, again, what's fundamental to who you are? That's your character on the inside. That's your dreams and vision on the inside. That's to a certain degree the way you look. I know you can kind of change the way you look, right? But like, for example, I will never ever look like a blonde, blue-eyed, you know, woman, right? I mean, I could get blonde hair and I could get blue contacts, I guess, but you know what I mean? My skin is this color, right? For example, I can't change that about who I am. I can't change the fact that I don't look like everyone else. You know, I'm mixed race, right? But I can own every single inch of this and find the beauty in this. And in doing that, I attracted in someone who thinks I'm the most beautiful woman in the world. So I want you to liberate yourself from the idea that you have to fundamentally change who you are. We talk about this so much in my Man Attraction Bootcamp program, and then even deeper in, you know, Get and Keep Your Man. The right man for you will see you in front of him and think that all of you is perfect. Just like Gal Gadot was like the perfect person for Wonder Woman, right? She was the perfect character. Like if Reese Witherspoon, love Reese Witherspoon, right? I love Big Little Lies. Like, but can you imagine Reese Witherspoon in that Wonder Woman role? It wasn't the right match, right? And I don't know if she was up for that role. I'm just saying, giving you an example. She was. There is the right match for you. And you won't get it by believing that you have to change who you fundamentally are. And there was one more thing that I wanted to share from this magazine. This is just how my brain thinks, you guys. It's like I'm sitting reading Elle magazine and I'm thinking of how I can apply it to help all of you guys. So there's this other article I found really interesting on Brigitte Macron. So she is the wife of the French president, right? And here's what's really interesting about her. I didn't know this. She is, I think it's 24 years older than her husband. And, you know, she's super fashionable and she looks great, but she's 24 years older. And she said something here that I really liked. Give me a moment to try and find this because, you know, people are always asking them, like, I guess it's like a big deal, right? Like, oh my God, she's such an older woman. And I have clients who ask me this, like, how can I have the confidence to get a younger man? And I'll say, you have to look for the examples. But she said something in here that I really liked because it wasn't about changing who she is. I'm gonna see if I can find the exact quote. Give me a second. By the way, if you guys have questions, now would be a good time to type them while I'm looking for the exact quote. If I can't find it, I'll just paraphrase. Michelle saying, all I date are younger men, yeah. And you're amazing, and they should want you. Well, anyway, she said they don't waste any time worrying about the age difference. And so what she said in this article was, she said, you know what? At the end of the day, at breakfast, it's just him sitting there and me with my wrinkles. I'm paraphrasing that. But she's not trying to change how she looks to be with him. She's sitting across from him. He's a much younger man. She's sitting there across from him with her wrinkles. She's 20 years older, 24 years older than him. And it wasn't this energy of like, oh, I had to get Botox and I had to do these things and I had to change myself. No, can you imagine her sitting, like understanding, all right, he's 24 years younger. We're sitting here, I've got my wrinkles and we still have this great relationship. And she said like, it just felt like a match. And she actually had to, you know, she said it was hard on her family because she has children at first and they didn't understand. But she said like, I just had to go for this love. And so this is just another example, you guys, of, you know, she's now the first lady, right, of France. And she has a husband that's 24 years younger. And I mean, she's sexy and fit and all that stuff. But she's sitting there like owning like, yeah, I've got wrinkles. But it doesn't mean that she can't be with the love of her life who happens to be 24 years younger than her. So this is just another example of owning who you are, bringing that to the table. Can you imagine if she was getting in her head about, oh my God, he's so much younger. Is he gonna want me? Should I get Botox? Not that if you get Botox, it's not wrong. I mean, I don't judge that kind of stuff, right? But can you imagine if her energy was that instead of, wow, this is somebody that I really match with and knowing what she brings to the table. So how you attract in the one isn't changing who you are. I hate all the dating advice out there that's trying to tell you that you should just like play games. Don't sleep with him for 3 months or whatever. It's not about that. There is someone who's the right match for you. And the more you own what you're bringing to the table, and the more you own your unique gift, like Gal Gadot owned her accent. Like, I'm not gonna change this. I mean, thank God she had that voice teacher to tell her that, right? I'm not gonna change this. It's like you guys, some of you who are my clients, you have me to tell you, don't change who you fundamentally are. Let's find a way to celebrate it, because in that, you're gonna find the love of your life. So I hope this message is inspiring for any of you. Hi, Christina. Glad to see you live too. I hope this message is inspiring for any of you who have suffered under the idea that you must change who you fundamentally are to attract the love of your life. I know I thought that for a really long time. And I'm gonna tell you, you guys, it's incredible to be with someone who celebrates you for all that you are. It's incredible to be with someone where you can truly be all of who you are. I have that every day. And it's amazing. It's that like best friend feeling. Like, it's crazy to me that people are in relationship, romantic relationship with someone else, and they're not sharing the truth of who they are. It's crazy to me that people are in romantic relationship with someone else, and they're not feeling fully loved and celebrated. It's crazy to me that people are in romantic relationship with someone else, and they feel like they have to hide, or sacrifice, or change. And I've done all those things. But when on the other side of it, I can tell you it's actually insanity to believe that. Romantic relationship should be this safe haven feeling. It should be being loved and celebrated for exactly who you are. It should be the space of unconditional love. That's also what we should have experienced as a child. And I know many of you didn't. And that's where the craziness comes of thinking that you shouldn't get that in a romantic relationship. But please hear me on this. You're not meant to stay in the problem. You're meant to move to the solution. You're not meant to stay in lack of love. You're meant to move to abundant love. You're not meant to struggle and suffer in your love life and never have it, or he's not committing, or I have to change who I am, or I'm afraid of him. I'm in a relationship, but I really don't trust him, or any of that crap. You're not meant for that. You're meant for the transformation. You're meant for the rising. You're meant for the amazing, abundant love. Part of how you get that is this fierce ownership of who you are. So the right opportunity, the right person can come and grab you. So I just found it so inspiring. If anybody wants to actually read the articles, the article on Brigitte Macron and on Gal Gadot, that's in the, what is this? The December issue of Elle magazine. You can find inspiration for love everywhere. So I hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Love Works show. I hope you have an amazing week. It's Thanksgiving week here in the US. For those of you who aren't on my email list, please subscribe immediately at loveworksmethod.com, because I'm releasing an amazing Black Friday offer that I promise you don't want to miss. Every year I give away more and more and more and more and more, and I keep the price ridiculously low. And this year I'm giving away even more. So it's pretty crazy, like everything we're giving away for the price. So if you're not on my email list, you won't get access to that. So go to loveworksmethod.com to subscribe there. I hope you love yourselves more this week than you ever have. And I hope you have happy holidays. And thanks, love. And I will see you next week for the next episode of the Love Work Show. Bye, everyone. Can we share your promo? Oh, thanks so much, love. You know what? Probably. I just don't know how to do it anymore. Now that we switched to Infusionsoft, it's not, I don't know, but I'll see if I can figure it out, love. Thank you so much for offering to share that. That's so generous. If we can find the way, I will definitely send it to you. Happy Thanksgiving, Christina. Happy Thanksgiving, Lydia. Happy Thanksgiving, Michelle. Thankful for you. Aw, thankful for you. I'm so thankful for all of my amazing clients. Hi, Jennifer. Thank you. I really am so grateful for all of you who are my clients, because you are my business. Like, it's you guys, you know, it's you who are the ones who are my business, you know. Like, I'm incredibly grateful to you, because without you, I wouldn't have this Love Works business. Like, you are such an incredible part of it, and I love serving you. And for everyone who follows me, I love having you too, because you all give me an audience. You know, we have almost, I think, 20,000 people on my newsletter list, and that's growing every day. We have all of you guys watching the Love Work Show. We have all the people watching my YouTube videos. It's really incredible. And I'm in very much gratitude for all of you, because I created my business years ago, but you all coming in here, whether you are a client or whether you watch all of my free stuff and take a bunch of notes, I know there's some of you who literally have notebooks full of notes from all the content. It's really you guys that provide the platform for me to be able to do this. So I'm very, 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 very grateful for you. I hope you have happy holidays, and I hope that you set your heart this year on next year you having more love than you ever could imagine. Like whatever you love you had this year, just go ahead and think about it doubling next year, because that's entirely possible. All right, ladies, see you next week. Bye.